channel, man, and today's beat was brought to you by Coast Beats. Link in the description below is going to take you to downloadpaz.com, where you can find this particular beat tape with this particular beat on it and his contact information via Twitter. And if you holler at him to get some beats, tell him I sent you. But anyway, on to today's reply, and it's to that Freddie Gibbs and Madlib with Domo Genesis and Sweatshirt, that Robes, and you know what? This track here is pretty damn dope. And you guys know I'm not too huge on Odd Future, man. Honestly, I do feel as though that Domo Genesis is the best one out of it. And I'm happy that Freddie Gibbs and Domo Genesis collaborated for this track, man, because that was one that I've always wanted to hear. Never really been a fan of anybody else in all of Odd Future, man. But yet, on this track, actually everybody contributed pretty damn well, making this a pretty good fucking track. And you know, I've been anxiously anticipating this Cocaine Pinata, man, that got its release date pushed back to March 18th, by the way. But the reason why I've really been anticipating this, man, is because it is definitely something different. This is something I tell a lot of rappers, man. Whenever you come out, you typically want to find you a producer, ask them to give you the craziest different beats that you can fucking get, and you try to flip them joints. That way you can be completely different from all of your competition and shit. The last few songs that I've heard have been pretty fucking dope, dude. I definitely recommend you guys to go ahead and peep this one out, and I am definitely anticipating this Cocaine Pinata. I think this could legitimately be a top album of the year if it's done right. But anyway, on to Ask Download Path. And Bynum asks, what are the best ways to build a buzz? The best steps? And my brother, you're looking at it the wrong way. There is no best guaranteed step for anyone to build a buzz in the music industry, man. It's all based on you. Your own unique ideas, what you are willing to do, how creative you are, man. All of this shit matters when it comes to building your buzz. You have to create your own path to walk. There is no set path for you to walk and see success in this shit. And the reason for this is because every time someone comes out with a new path, everyone fucking follows that shit. To the point that you're just waiting in line. It's like you're waiting in traffic trying to get to the same place everyone else is getting, but yet they shut down the fucking road. You have to pave your own lane, man. Ain't nobody gonna do that shit for you, and the way you do it is up to you, but you definitely have to rely on hard work more than anything, because that's all the fuck you got. Don't matter how much money you got, don't matter how many connections you have, it's gonna all come down to how hard you fucking push. And Dreadhead Dude says, he feels as though Meek Mill is the most relevant artist out of Maybach right now, and I gotta disagree with you, my brother. Wale, hands down, is the most relevant, in which you cited the fact that Meek Mill's mixtapes be doing numbers, in which he does. But Wale's singles be doing numbers. And I'm not talking radio play numbers. I'm talking sales. Every single single he's ever dropped has gone gold. Look it up. Those types of numbers is pretty much why he leapfrogged Meek Mill in Maybach. Keep it 100.